God revealed himself to them
Katonda yabe yanjulira
as Jesus the Savior, the Lamb
Yesu,
of God.
Omulokozi, omwana wa Katonda.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That is what brought us salvation.
Katonda yatuletera obulokozi.
He died on the cross.
Yafira ku musalaba.
He paid for my sins.
Era nasasulira ebibi byange.
And he paid for me to become a child of God.
Nasasula nze nsobola okufuka omwana wa Katonda.
So I discovered him as the Lamb of God.
Era nange ne muzulanga omwana gw'endiga.
Who takes away the sins of the world.
Oyo ajjawe ebibi by'abantu.
But God began to speak to me that I'm not only the Lamb of God. Jesus began to speak to me. I am not only the Lamb of God. I am the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hey!
Hey!
Hey! He's not only the Lamb of God who humbled himself. And paid with his life to save us. He's also the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And God have mercy on you when he roars. Hallelujah. Set your neighbor, God have mercy on you when he roars. Amen. So God spoke to me. Up until now, I have revealed myself to you as the Lamb of God. Jesus spoke to me. But now I'm going to reveal myself to you as the I am, the warrior. Amen.
Amina.
So I said, okay, let's go. Praise the
Lord.
Let's go.
Nemugamba tugende.
Let's turn to Psalm 18.
Tugende mu kitabo kya Zaburi esura ya 18.
Verse 29.
Olunyiri tugenda kusoma olwabiri mu mwenda.
I'll read up to verse 34.
Tugenda kutuukira ddala ku nyiriri asatu munya.
These are the scriptures I'm going to share. I think near the end I'll share only two scriptures.
Era bwe nabanga natera okufundikira nja kugaba
n'enyiriri
nga nyezoka.
It will not be long. Psalm 18, verse 29. David says, for by you I can run against a troop.
Dawudi agamba kubanga mukubeerawo ku numba ekibiina.
And by my God I can leap over wall.
Era mukuyamba kwa Katonda wange mbuka ekigu.
As for God, his way is perfect.
Katonda ekubo lye lyatuukirira.
The word of the Lord is proven. He's a shield to all who trust him.
Ekigambo kya Mukama kiteebwa oyo yengabo yabo bonna abamwesiga.
For who is God except the Lord?
Kubanga ani Katonda wabula Mukama.
Who is a rock except our God?
Era ani lwazi wabula Katonda wafe.
It is God who arms me with strength.
Katonda ansibye amanyi.
And makes my way perfect.
Era atuukirize kubo lyange.
Now before we read verse
33,
I want you to think about David. In the Bible you have two men who fought battles all their lives.
Bible inamu abasajja babiri abaalwana entalo obulamu bwabwe bonna.
Joshua and David.
Yosua ne Daudi.
Here we are talking of David.
Kati twogera ku Daudi.
Listen to his confession.
Wulirizo kwatula kwe.
He says,
agamba,
by God's help I can run against a troop. Hallelujah. Look at me. David is saying, when there is a troop of soldiers coming against me, and I'm alone, by God's help, I can confront them and drive them back. Hey, you have already gone to sleep.
Katimweva said that.
It is morning. It is not.
Wakachia sitemuna ziba.
Hallelujah.
Mukama yeva zwe.
David is saying.
Dawudi agamba.
When a troop comes against me.
Ejewe di jajendi.
By my God, I can run against the troop.
Olwakatonda wange nsobolo kuri nganga.
Amen.
Amina.
Then he says,
era nadamu naagamba,
he trains my hands to do warfare.
Oyo atendeke mikono jangu okulwana.
He trains my hands to do. Let's read from verse 33.
Katusome,
he makes my feet like the feet of a deer.
Afure bigere byange ngebyempewo.
And he sets me on my high places. Meaning when David is running against his enemies. He runs like a deer. You wonder where did he get the speed from? He says God is the one who helps
me.
And then the last verse we're reading.
34.
He says he teaches my hands to make war.
Agamba, anjigirize engalo zange okulwana.
So that my arm can bend a bow of bronze.
Emikono jange nejirega omutego ogwechikomo.
Amen.
Amina.
Many of you think David was just a physical warrior.
Abamu mulowooza nti Dawudi yali mulwanyi ono w'emikono n'ebikonde.
You read his confession.
Gwesoma okwatula kwe kuno.
So throughout life God taught David to do warfare.
Okuyita mu bulamu Katonda yayigiriza Dawudi okulwana.
The last 9 years,
emyaka omwenda egiyise,
God has been training my hands to do warfare.
Katonda abadde ayigiriza emikono gyange okulwana.
Today I can bend a bow of bronze. Lero nange nsobola
okulega akasala akechikomo.
Beware.
Mwegendereze kati.
Today I can leap over wall.
Lero nange ebisenge nsobola bibuka.
Today I can run against a troop.
Nsobola n'okulumba eje damba.
Because of God's spiritual warfare school the last 9 years.
Olw'okubanga emyaka omwenda Katonda abadde antutte mu ssomero ery'okulwana.
5 lessons.
Amasomo atano.
Number one. anointing of Elijah will come upon the church.
Inti amafuta geria gajja kukaku kanisa.
To keep the security of physical political nations.
Okutebenkeza ebyobukulembeze ebyeggwanga ebirabikako.
Did you hear me?
Mumpulidde bulungi.
Amen.
Amina.
Let me tell you, brothers and sisters.
Kambabulire baganda bange.
The security of nations is no longer in the hands of police and army. Even powerful nations are failing now. I hope you have been following
the
news. God is expecting you. As you have heard the word of the general overseer to take the security of the nation and your village as one of the aspects of establishing God's kingdom
there.
When I come to your village and there is so much insecurity, I ask myself, are there sons of the kingdom here? There was a gathering of the Fellowship of Born Again Pentecostal Churches led by Bishop
Lwere.
They have invited me twice to share with all their national leaders this very message. So they have now picked it up and they are taking the security of their locations in the same way. It is the church, sons of the kingdom, who have the mandate to do what Elisha did in Israel. Don't blame politicians. Don't blame police and army. They cannot police every village, every home. But the church can bring God's kingdom by bringing even physical security in villages. I hope you are hearing what I'm talking about. The message our general overseer has given to us is not only in simple religious things. We bring the kingdom of God even security. And we have been doing this from my office in town from 2015. Amen.
Amen.
Prayer walking and prayer patrolling. Number three. This one is powerful. A few years ago, chaos returned to the city. Do you remember street traders have moved off? And after the last elections, they returned. How many of you remember? Now listen to me. One of those days, I took a walk from my office down to the park, then up Namirembe Road. It took me about 1.5 hours moving around those streets. And as I was coming back, KCCA law enforcement vehicles, you know those pickups, they were driving past, and I saw the traders who used to run away whenever those vehicles would appear. This time they didn't run away because anarchy had returned to the city. They were no longer respecting those vehicles and those law enforcement officers. As I was praying, I said, Lord, who is in charge here? Because the law enforcement officers are no longer in charge. The Holy Spirit spoke to me. You take charge. I said, hey, you take charge. I went back to our intercessors. I mobilized them. We began to come into town at 6:30 every day.
Ne tutandika okuyingiranga mu kibuga saawa 12 n'ekitundu buli lunaku.
Six different teams.
Ebibinja mukaaga.
One Monday, another on Tuesday, another on Wednesday, up to Saturday. And we began to prayer walking into those areas of Anake. Not carrying sticks, but carrying prayer. Amen.
Amina.
So we began going into the places of Anake. Not disturbing anybody, but just praying. After only a few days, government intervened.
Government neyingira
and drove away the Anake from the streets. God began to speak to me. That is the way we address Anake. Let me tell you what I do these days. When I hear there is a trouble in Kiseka market, I pray. I say, Lord, what do I do?
Ningama mukama chichi mbankola.
When God tells me, gives me release,
Katonda mwansumulula,
I just walk there.
Intambula butambuzi.
Not walking to confront those who are demonstrating.
Sikugenda yo kutandika kusisinkana bana abekalakasa.
But I go pretending I'm just passing by.
Kati nange ngena nefulanga ayita obwisi.
Are you getting me?
Muntegera.
Praying.
Ninga nsaba.
I carry a battalion of angels.
Inze nsitula ekibinja kyaba malaika.
The Bible talks of Elisha.
Bible yeyogera ku Elisa.
When there was a young man whose eyes were closed to spiritual things.
We wali wo muvubuka maso gagali gasibye ngatalaba byamuyo.
Elisha said, "Open his eyes, Lord."
Elisa nagamba mukama gula maso ge.
And he saw on the whole of hillside.
Era nalaba obusozi bonna omwali bulinanyewo.
Angels of fire.
Bamalaika abalina omuliro.
Chariots of fire.
Amagali ag'omuliro.
And horses of fire.
Era n'embalaasi ez'omuliro.
Around about the man of God.
Inga zetolodde omusajja wa Katonda.
Did you hear me?
Mumpulidde.
So when Elisha would be moving,
buli Elisa bwe yatambulanga,
these small demons, they would see chariots of fire.
Obuzibu buno obutono nga bulaba amagaali agaliko omuliro ne bamalayika abakutte omuliro.
So some of you, God is raising you as Elijah.
Kati abamu ku mmwe Katonda abasitulanga Elisa.
And Elisha.
Era ne Eliya.
In the kingdom of God, they are ranks. They are the local, they are the low men who have just joined the army.
And
then you have captains. And you have brigadiers. And you also have field marshals. Tell somebody that is Elisha. Hey, you're not talking. That is Elisha. So when you rise in your ranks, because of the experience and training God has given to you, and the revelation of God which has come into your life, as you move in those areas of chaos, and somebody's shouting, you know, those funny political slogans, and you just come near them. You may even greet them. They don't know what is happening. The horses of fire and chariots of fire. You just walk through and then you discover the thing has quieted down. The church has been given tremendous power. We take charge. Take charge. When there is a demonstration in your institution, in your school, you get a few people
kunga y'abantu abatono
of your intercessors,
abo saba nabo,
and go and take charge.
Mugende mukwate nkasi.
It is incredible what happens when you take charge.
Ojja kwewunya kyekijja okubaawo nga mukutte nkasi.
These are lessons I've learned the last 9 years.
Bino byebimu ku byenjiza emyaka omwenda egiyise.
Number 4.
Ekyokuna.
And we'll soon conclude.
Tunaatera okuwunzika.
Commanding God's rule over the city and nation. This one is
okulangirira okufuga kwa Katonda okwetoloola ekibuga n'eggwanga.
Now listen very carefully here.
Mumpulirize bulungi ku kino.
Because I'm going to talk in parables.
Kubanga ngenda kwogera mu ngero.
Because I don't want to mention names.
Saagala kumenya mannya.
Of powerful people in the land.
O abantu abanaggwano mu ggwanga.
Amen.
Amina.
God began to speak to us.
Katonda yatandika okwogera naffe.
During that time of anarchy in the city.
Mu kaseera ako ekibuga bwe kyajjula obutabanguko.
That it is sons of the kingdom.
N'atugamba nti mwe abaana ab'obwakabaka.
To command the affairs of the nation.
Mwe abateekeddwa okulagira n'okulambika eby'eggwanga, entambuza y'eggwanga.
How?
Butya.
By prayer.
Mukuyita mu kusaba.
These last few months,
ennaku zino entono eziyise,
I told you about those drives in the city every morning, twice.
Mbagambyeko kuno okuvuga okw'emirundi ebiri kwe tukola mu kibuga buli ku makya.
God told us,
Katonda yatugamba,
to command the day,
okulagira olunaku.
Amen.
Amina.
So as we drive around,
nga tuvuga ku makya,
many times it's with my wife, the others do some walks and so on, but
emirundi egisinga mbeera ne mukyala wange bali abalala betusaba nabo babeera batambula.
Amen.
Amina.
We drive around,
nga tuvuga,
and we pray like this. Listen to the prayer.
Tusaba bwetu tiwulirize.
It will teach faster than explaining.
Ejja kuyigiriza mangu nnyo okusinga nze okunnyonnyola.
We say, Lord, as we drive around this city.
Nti Mukama nga bwe tuvuga emmotoka okwetoloola ekibuga kino.
This is the seat of our government.
Kino y'entebe ya gavumenti yaffe.
It is the seat of our parliament.
Era eno y'entebe eya parliament yaffe.
The Bible teaches us.
Bible yetusomesa.
You are our lawgiver.
Yegwe omugabi w'amateeka owaffe.
Meaning you are our legislator. Parliament.
Ekitegeeza nti gwe mubaka waffe.
Today, Lord.
Lero Mukama.
We invite you into our parliament.
Tukwaniriza mu lukiiko lw'eggwanga.
As the chief lawgiver.
Inga gwe omuyi w'amateeka omukulu.
Our members of parliament, many of them are corrupt.
Abaka bafa aba parliament abasinga bali banguzi.
Lord, we are praying.
Mukama tusaba.
That as lawgiver,
inti gwenga omugabi w'amateeka,
you take your seat in parliament.
Jangu otware ekifocho mu lukiiko lw'eggwanga olukulu.
That today we are commanding not evil legislation will come from our parliament.
In the name of Jesus.
Whoever has gone to consult witchcraft and has come with wicked thinking, we are praying that as they enter parliament gates, establish there a guard of soldiers, warriors, spiritual soldiers.
Take a wo, abasirikale, abomoyo, abalwanyi.
With fire.
Abajina no muliro.
So that as these guys enter,
ngabayingira bwebati,
those demons which came upon them,
emizimu gino egyabajiddeko,
when they were waiting in the sorcery places,
ngabalindiridde eri mu nsazi,
the demons will see fire.
Emizimu gino giraba omuliro.
They will say, you member of parliament,
gigambe gwe mubaka wa parliament,
where are you taking us?
Kati ate fo tutwala wa?
Please go alone, we are not coming.
Gunda bibyo naffe katuddeyo.
Are you getting it?
Mufuna.
We command God's guard on the gates.
Tulangirira omu abafuzi bwa Katonda okukuma wankachi.
What does it mean to rule with Christ?
Chiche chitegeza okufugira wamu ne Kristo.
We are seated with Christ in heavenly places.
Tutude wamu ne Kristo mbife bya waguru.
We enforce His rule.
Kati fe wano kunsifa abakakatawo okufuga kwe.
We enforce His rule.
Fe abakakatawo okufuga kwe.
And so we move around.
Era ne tutane tweyongera
yo. We say, Lord.
Netugamba Mukama.
When he sat on the throne, the Bible says,
Bible yetu gamba,
Solomon sat on God's throne.
Solomani yatula kunamulondo ya Katonda.
Have you ever read that?
Echo mwali mukisomieko.
Solomon sat on God's throne.
Bible yegamba Solomani yatula kunamulondo ya Katonda.
The thrones of nations,
namulondo za mawanga,
they belong to the Lord.
Za Katonda.
Say amen.
Gamba amina.
The thrones of the nations,
n'entebezo w'akabaka
ezamawanga, they belong to the Lord.
Nazo za Katonda.
Solomon sat on God's throne.
Sulumani yatula ku ntebe ya Katonda.
Praise the name of God.
Mukama yebazibwe.
And so as we pray going around,
nga tutambula nga tusaba,
we say, Lord,
tugamba Mukama,
the throne of our nation,
entebe y'eggwanga lyaffe,
belongs to you.
Yiyo.
Today we are asking you.
Lero tukusaba.
Come and sit on it.
Jango jituleko.
Come and sit on it.
Jango jituleko.
There was a man called Cyrus.
Wali womusajja eyali amanyiddwa nga Sira.
In Persia.
Owe Persia.
He sat on the throne of Persia.
Yatula kuntebe eyo.
And he said,
Nagamba,
the God of the Jews,
Inti Katonda waba Yudaya,
from Judah,
okuve ye Yuda,
he
Yuda,
has commanded me
and Agidens
to build him a house in Jerusalem.
Okumuzimbire nyumba Yerusalem.
How can Cyrus be commanded by God?
Kati Sira alagirwa atya Katonda.
He was sitting on a throne.
Kubanga yali atudde kunamulondo.
There were people like Daniel and Esther and others who had prayed.
Waliwo abantu nga Danieli ne Esther n'abalala abaali basabye.
They commanded that throne to be God's throne. And when Cyrus sat on it, he didn't know he was sitting on God's throne. And now God began to command through him. Listen, brothers and sisters, there is a level. There is a level. There is a level where the thrones of the nations can be commanded by children of God. Not sitting on it, you are off the throne like Daniel, like Esther, like
Mordecai,
and yet you command what goes on there. Are you getting what I'm talking about? Are you getting what I'm talking about? I am no longer worried. I leave politics into your hands.
Politics,
some of you are DPs. Others are movementists. Others are forum for the
Forum for Democratic Change.
Listen. For me, I'm a son of the kingdom. Let any of those sit there. Now God has given me one of the keys of the kingdom to command what goes on there. Are you getting it? So we say, Lord, today, that throne, we are commanding that only God's will be done there. Like you commanded Cyrus, and he commanded for the house of the Lord to be constructed in Jerusalem. We are enforcing your rule on that throne. Today, no wicked decisions are going to
be done.
Any advisors, advisors to this throne, those who spent the night in in shrines, we command that they don't enter there. That power which they got from shrine, we are saying as they come in, they will see angels of fire guarding the throne, and the demons will run away. And when they come with the wrong advice, it will not be executed. Are you getting what I'm talking about? God is training our hands to do warfare. I hope you are getting the lesson. The last one. I've already mentioned it. But I'll just say, read it for the notes. Number 5. The thrones of the nations are God's throne. Turn to 1 Kings chapter 2. Verse 12. Can you put it up on the screen, somebody? Okay. It reads then 1 Kings chapter 2, verse 12. Then Solomon sat on the throne of his father David, and his kingdom was firmly established.
Ntiawo Sulumani natula ku ntebe ya kitawe Daudi era obwakabaka bwe ne bukakata.
Now I want you to open 1 Chronicles chapter 29.
Njagala tugende mbyo mirembe ekisoka esule ya 2 mwenda.
Verse 23.
Olinyi tugenda kusoma lwa 2 musatu.
Sorry, I've taken time, but I am happy you are getting the point.
Munsa sire ntutta akadde kawanvuko nendi musanyufu nti mubitegedde.
Okay. Now in the book of Chronicles, it is rendered differently. Then Solomon sat on the throne of the Lord as king instead of David his father. And he prospered and Israel obeyed him. Read it after me in English. Then Solomon sat on the throne of the Lord as a king instead of David. The thrones of the nations, they belong to the Lord. As we come to 2019, as you realize, for me there is a lot of excitement. I no longer look at the limitations of human
beings.
God is training our hands to do
this.
And as we move into 2019, you go during the day-to-day as church pastors, for example, you ask yourself, what is the parish? What is the parish God has given to us as a local church? The area where God wants us to preach the gospel and to enforce his rule there. What is our parish? What is our territory? According to these five items Pastor Laban has shared, what is God saying that we can take this territory for God? Do we need to do prayer camping somewhere? Do we need to do prayer patrols in the area? Is there insecurity which we need to chase out of the area? Is there immorality and drunkenness in our parish? How do we defeat those places? Are you getting what I'm talking about? I am waiting for a year later, the end of 2019. I want you to come here and give testimonies that when we enter 2019, our parish had many sorcerers. It had many bars. It had many orgies of people going to immorality. And we prayed. And God told us to do this or this or this or this. And above all of those are the preparation for preaching the gospel. When you are preaching in a place where God is not ruling, things will be very hard. But when the enemy is subdued, it's like a walkover. Are you getting what I'm talking about? For me, 2019 is the year for God's kingdom to invade places. 2019 is the year for God's kingdom to invade and take over many domains and territories. We are poised. I'm about to command. Ready? Set?
Go.
Amen.
Amina.
So this night of entering the new year is a night for us to get ready.
Kati chiro chafe kwetandika kwetekateka.
So I'm going to invite my fellow leaders here.
Katikanyanirize bakulembeze bannange.
To come and stand with me here.
Baje bayimirire wano nange.
To get you into ready, set.
Tutandike okubuguma olo tutandike tusimbule tugende.
We are poised.
Kubanga tuwulira wetutuuse tutandise tweteeseteese.
Being poised means you are ready to run.
Kitegeeza nti obugumye oli mwetefutefu okugenda.
The word poised is P-O-I.
Ekigambo ekyo kyayogedde kiteekwa okubeera mu mbeera netefutefu okutandika.
Like an animal ready to run.
Ng'ensolo ebeera ebugumye ng'ebulako kugigamba nti genda.
Okay, you leaders led by
kati abakulembeze mujje.
Come forward and we get this army to get poised.
Mujye tuletere jerino kubera mumbere yobwetefutefu.
Amen. Every team lead, every member of the team who is here, you come forward.
Buri member wa team ali wano jangu.
Because we're the commanders of the army of the Lord.
Kubanga fe badumizi ba majega katonda.
We are poised for great and exciting year ahead.
Fe tubugumiride era tweteeseteese okulaba omwaka ogw'amaanyi ogugenda okutandika.
It is going to be a year of much prayer.
Omwaka gugenda kuba gujjudde sala
and devotion to God.
Era n'okwewaayo ennyo eri Katonda.
And a year of great answers.
Era n'omwaka ogujjudde ebyokuddamu ebingi.
And victories.
N'obuwanguzi.
We are sons of the kingdom.
Fe tuli baana ab'obwakabaka.
God's kingdom must invade and subdue many institutions.
Kati obwakabaka bwa Katonda bwina okujja butware ebitundu ebisinga.
And many domains.
Era n'obunyomero bwonna.
And many territories.
N'ebitundu ebisinga.
For the kingdom of God.
Ku lw'obwakabaka bwa Katonda.
I want you to stand up.
Njagala ffenna tuyimirire.
Amen. How many of you are poised, ready to enter 2019?
Bameka owulira nga w'oli obugumiridde.
And to take the rule of the kingdom of God in your domain. Amen. Amen. I've given you a few of the lessons God has taught me in the last 9 years. Take me to any situation of anarchy. Take me to any situation of anarchy.
We
just go there simply. But by the command of the Holy Spirit. And anarchy is commanded to come down. I don't think you have understood what I'm talking about. When the situation was very bad in Burundi. About 3 years ago, God spoke to us to take a team there. So we took a team, was it 4 or 5 people? I don't remember. And we were joined by others in
Burundi.
And we started driving around Bujumbura. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Beginning at 9 o'clock and ending at 5 o'clock because night was very insecure. People were being killed. Anarchy had come to Burundi. At the end of the week, we boarded our plane to come back. And we told the brethren in Burundi to continue what we had taught them. We told our brethren we had been
working
around them. What we had taught them. They continued. After a few weeks, the killings stopped. The place became quiet. You remember the last 2 years, Burundi has been quiet. The political situation didn't change. But the chaos stopped. A few months ago, I began to hear trouble was back in Burundi. 2 weeks ago, I got a burden. Is it 3 weeks ago when you went to Rwanda? My wife was going to Rwanda for some business. I asked her to contact the person related to us spiritually who Who knows what is going on in Burundi?
Era ne musaba abeko omuntu gwaba kwanangana naye amanyi mu byomwoyo amanyi butereevu ebigenda maaso mu Burundi.
To ask them if I can come to Burundi for a few days.
Era ne musaba amumbulize oba nsobola okujjako e Burundi ennaku entonotono.
When he got the information that Laban is ready to come,
bwe yafuna obubaka nti Laban mwetegefu okujja,
he was very happy.
Yali musanyufu nnyo.
He said throughout the English speaking world, people in Christmas, they don't want to come.
Era n'agamba nti mawanga agasinga agogera oluzungu abantu bali mu bya sekukulu tebaagala kujja.
But if you are ready to come, please come.
Naye bw'obanga gwe oli mwetefutefu tukusanyukidde.
So I booked an air ticket.
Ne nfuna ennyonyi.
Flew into Bujumbura.
Ne ngenda e Bujumbura.
It was a night flight. I arrived in the morning at about 9 o'clock.
Ennyonyi yali ya kiro natuuka ku ssaawa nga 3 ez'okumakya.
And when I got there,
bwe natuuka eyo,
even the immigration forms
kati nekipapula ekikuweebwa ng'oyingira eggwanga,
at the bottom there
wansi wano,
the immigration officer puts a tick whether you are a suspect or not a suspect.
Kati ono akugamba nti yingira oba toyingira alina watiikinga oba oteeberezebwa oba toteeberezebwa.
If I had the liberty, I would have photographed it for you to show, but I didn't to see. But I didn't want to be a suspect, so I didn't get my.
Kati singa nanina obudde nali chakubye chifana ine kabalaga naye sayagala kulabi kanga atebelezebwa.
The situation is tense.
Embera ya bunkenke.
I got into Burundi, Bujumbura. I went to the hotel where brethren had, you know, planned for me. And from there I went to the church right away. It was Sunday morning.
I preached Sunday.
Preached on Monday. They put on special meeting Monday morning, Monday evening.
Era Monday kumacha n'olweggulo bateka enkungana ne
tuzibulira
ne kumacha ku lwokubiri.
And then I left for the airport.
Era nevayo ningenda ku kisaawe ky'ennyonyi.
I came back safely here. When I got here, people told me Ugandan is going to Burundi, they are being stopped and so on.
Kati bwe natuuka wano, bangamba nti bana Uganda abava wano okugenda e Burundi bakugirwa.
For me, I went under the leading of the Holy Spirit and I went in and did my work.
Kati nze nagenda nga nungamizi w'omwoyo mutukuvu, nengenda nenkola ebyantu alera nenkomawo.
Praise God.
Mukama yebazibwe.
The last meeting of Tuesday, my word to them was, God says, I'll never leave you nor forsake
you.
God tells you, church in Burundi, He will never leave you nor forsake
you.
I shared for about 30 minutes. And I could see smiles coming back on their faces. People who had been so sad and feeling forsaken. Praise God. Are you getting what I'm talking about? I'm talking about sons of the kingdom. I'm talking about spiritual warriors. Amen. This is what we're going into in 2019. Last weekend, when I was in Burundi, God stirred my heart. Of all East African nations, I have been there many times, like in Kenya, I've been there several times. Tanzania, I've not been there for some years. And God stirred my heart. You are the lead of East African intercessors for Africa.
Katonda yasikula omutima gwange ng'omukulembeze w'abegayirizi mu East Africa.
And you have neglected Tanzania.
Era nga mpulira nti eggwanga lya Tanzania nalindire kulidde.
I determined,
nensalawo,
I'll go to Tanzania before the year ends.
Ngenda gende Tanzania ng'omwaka tegunnaggwako.
So when I returned from Burundi,
bwe nava e Burundi,
I checked the airlines again.
Nengezaako kebera ku by'ennyonyi.
I found a very convenient flight on Boxing Day.
Kati ku lunaku oludi oluvannyuma lwa Christmas nensangawo nga waliwo ennyonyi.
Where I could go to Dar es Salaam.
Era ng'esobola okutwala butereevu mu kibuga Dar es Salaam.
I arrive at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Nga nsobola okutuuka ku ssaawa 2 ez'okumakya.
And I leave at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Ate nga nsobola n'okuvaayo ku ssaawa 9 ez'ettungu.
I said I'll go.
Neŋŋamba nja kugenda.
And I'll get a vehicle for hire.
Era nengamba bwe natuukayo nja kupangisa emmotoka.
And I'll patrol Tanzania, Dar es Salaam.
Tandika okwetoloola ekibuga Dar es Salaam.
And then drive back to the airport.
Olwo bwe nakimaliriza nvuga enzireyo kusaba ekyenyo.
I rang the brethren.
Nekubira abooluganda.
They were too busy.
Baali n'ebyokola bingi.
Then in the morning of 20 of Christmas, In the night of Christmas, before my travel on Boxing Day, the name of a sister in the Lord who got widowed 7 years ago. It came into my spirit. It was 10 o'clock at night. I picked my phone. I rang her number because I had it on my phone. Some of the phones have changed.
But this one was on.
She picked it. I said, this is Pastor Laban
Jumba.
She said, Pastor, I'm very happy to hear you. This is a surprise. I said, I'm sorry to ring you so late in the night. But I'm coming to Jerusalem in the morning. She said, I'll be there at the airport to wait for you. Sure enough, she was there at 8 o'clock. She had a Porsche Prado.
Yaine moto kaprade nunji.
Amen. Air condition.
Nga elimu na akawewo.
You know at the ocean
Omanyi,
the humidity, the place is hot.
Okulinana semayanja embera yaye bela elimu bugumu eliwera.
I entered the vehicle.
Ne nyingire motoka.
She told me, Pastor,
nangama musumba.
A week ago,
sabiti eise,
my car had broken down a few months ago. And I put it aside. A week ago, God told me to repair this vehicle. I didn't know why. So I took it to the mechanics. They repaired it. And it's in very good condition now. When you rang me last night, I knew why God wanted me to
do
that. So I sat in this Porsche Prado, and we patrolled the city of
Jerusalem.
I took photographs, I have proof. State house, government offices, parliament.
Parliament
is in Dodoma. They don't have parliament. Amen. Are you getting what I'm talking about? There is obedience to what God commands you to do. There is a faith. Daring. Daring. But we're going to enforce the rule of the kingdom of God. I had changed some money into dollars which I wanted to give to her. She said, no, Pastor, I feel I should contribute to something to you. She gave me some Tanzania shillings. I didn't want to take it from a widow. Instead, I had wanted to give her some dollars. She said, Pastor, you have to take this one. I boarded the plane and came back. Sorry to lengthen it. But I'm demonstrating, when you obey, God is going to respond.
We're
going to command God's kingdom over nations. We are going to command God's kingdom over nations. Some of you are at the level of nations. Some of you are at the level of districts. Some of you are at the level of cities. And some of you are at the level of your institutions. When you are at the level of institutions, don't go to command cities. The devil will kill you.
Okay, we're now going to pray. Amen. Praise
God. Raise your right hand before God. And I'm going to lead in prayer. And then I will ask our general overseer, God will help him to form the prayer which says, ready, set, katonda ajja kumukulembera akole sala egamba nti mwetesetese kati tusimbule tugende to usher us into 2019 okutuyingiza omwaka 2019 amen amina god will give him the language and the words katonda ajja kumuwa ebigambo in the spirit to get us to ready set go olulimi okutusimbula okugenda Lord our God, I want to thank you very much for the last hour or so. Chitafe katonda bafenja galo kweba zakuru sawa ngenamba jitugabanye. Where I've shared your word. Awengabani de chigambo cho. What you have done in my life. Olwebyo byokozembula mu bwange. The last 9 years. Emyaka omwende jise. The many miracles. Ebyamagere nkuyanja. Of transformation. Ebyokuchusebwa. Of peace and quiet. Owe mirembe no busirifu. Of touching nation. Okukoma ku mawanga. Of influencing thrones. Of enforcing righteous decisions. Thank you. That even during that period, the devil's attacks have been vicious. But you have delivered us from them all. Thank you. Now, Lord, as you spoke to me, that my experience of the last 9 years, I must pass it on to the body of Christ. That men and women, pass and leaders who stand as captains of the Lord's army in the domains where you have placed them to enforce your rule there following some of the lessons learned in the last 9 years and to make sure that your kingdom takes over domains that your kingdom takes over cities, villages, communities, even in nations. Lord, I'm praying that Deliverance Church, Mukama Samanti Deliverance Church, as a church movement, Inge Kanisa, will spearhead in the invasion of your kingdom, in communities, in territories, in institutions, in schools, in hospitals, in businesses, that wherever we have our members, there will be sons of the kingdom there to enforce your rule there. Let 2019 be a victorious year for the church. A year where at the end of the year we shall give testimonies like I have given today of the powerful miracles you have performed through our life the last 9 years. We praise your name. We glorify your name. We are ready to move with you into 2019. Be to us God the I am. Be to us God the man of war. Be to us the one who trains our hands to do warfare. To subdue your enemies everywhere. And to enforce your rule in our land. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we raise our hands still? Father, we bless you for this morning. It is very clear, Lord, that you've spoken to us. That you want us, Lord, to bring your kingdom to come. And we want to thank you, King of Glory, for who are we, Lord God, to receive this from you. We count it a privilege, Lord God, Almighty Father, to be the people that you've chosen to work with. And Lord, we humble ourselves and submit to your will. Lord, we do not know all the details that are involved. But our trust is in you. You said in your words, not by power,
ekigambo kyo kigamba sirwa amaanyi,
it's not by might,
sirwa buyinza,
it's not but by your spirit,
naye olw'omwoyo wo.
And Lord, as a church, as Deliverance Church Uganda,
in that Deliverance Church Uganda,
we submit your will. We say, yes, Lord. We will go where you want us to go. We will do what you want us to do. We want to obey you in every instruction that you are going to give. We ask for your grace, mighty Father. Abundant grace. Lord, to be observant, to be alert, to be responsive when the Holy Spirit prompts us to
glory,
to pay attention to what is happening. Lord, we shall not miss any opportunity that you bring before
so
us. Lord, we surrender to you. And we are saying we are ready. Like Isaiah said, here I am. Lord,
you're
saying, here we are. Send us more. We are ready. We lay down our fears. We lay down our limitations. We lay down our inabilities. And embrace this mission, this work that you've given to us. And
we
say, Lord, have your way in us. We are ready to go. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
So as a team, we're going to stand here.
And
we're going to say, ready,
set,
go!
Amen.
So, you're going to lead us.
Ready?
Mwete setese.
Set.
Tuetegeke.
Let's go.
Tugende.
Amen.
Amina.